Hello and welcome back. We are straight into our next best of three as the camera is doing that really annoying thing where it's picking up the microphone. I've really got to fix that as I'm not a clever man. I haven't. But Soggy Mitts up against King Owl Plus 4, formerly known as Pain Gaming from Brazil. Going to be taking this best of three through the Americas qualifiers for ESL 1 Genting 2017. Joined by Skim Gaming. How are you doing, man? Oh dear. Rip Cocaster. Skim is dead. Probably after the other best of three, ran to get a drink.
Oh, hello?
There we go. Oh, you forgot to unmute.
Definitely forgot to unmute. I'm still on a high after that game. I didn't get the result that I needed after that back and forth. So I hope these two teams can give it to me.
Oh, fast drafting here. Right, I was fortunate enough to go to Brazil, cast WSG over there for the Americas games, and King Owl Plus 4 were one of our finalists against Infamous. They did reasonably well. Unfortunately, there were no NA teams at WSG due to some visa issues, but King Owl Plus 4, they looked reasonably good. You know, kind of judging by the opponents they were against, they were definitely the one of the favorites to go through to the grand finals. They fell at the last hurdle and kind of got tilted in the second game against Infamous, but their drafting seems relatively solid, got good players, and I kind of know what to expect from them. Soggy Mitts, for me, and I'm guessing from the little chuckles that you're giving, are almost a complete unknown from kind of just a cursory glance at their draft history.
You gotta give it to that name though, Soggy Mitts.
Mm.
How much more Canadian can you be?
I don't know. You could put a hockey pun in there or something.
I guess, yeah.
Maybe the mitts are soggy through maple syrup or something. I don't know.
I will say that some of these names are somewhat... I mean, for all I know, they're not even their official names, but some of these names... I'm trying to find any teams they have played before on before, or if they are just newcomers, but they seem familiar. No, but yeah, as for King Owl or former Pain Gaming, it's, you know how a lot of times people have used Team Empire as this like gateway team between Tier 1 and Tier 2 in Europe?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, if you're better than Team Empire, you're going to be like Tier 1, and if you're worse, you're likely Tier 2. I think you can look at Pain Gaming and almost say the same. I wouldn't quite say that beating them necessarily puts you into Tier 1, but they're sort of up there. They've always been this like Tier 2 team that has like poked towards Tier 1, and I think sometimes they've had performances where like, hey, you know what, they could be one of the top teams in NA, SA, but
what?
Then...
No, I'm not whatting at you, sorry, but...
No, I know.
I get what you're saying, they're kind of like that indicator team, the flag team, like, hey, you beat them, you're on the road to success, but... Okay, so Soggy Mitts open with a Drowrange of Vengeful Spirit, which... screams Drow Draft. After that, usually what we see is, you know, like a control mid, like a Puck, something along those lines, sometimes an Invoker. But Nature's Prophet is a hero that we have not seen in a long time.
For good reason. It's a hero that, and I think this is one of the biggest reasons why he is not good right now, is that you just don't really dual lane with him, do you? Like, the laning stage already is pretty off. Split pushing is not really that big of a thing right now, just because, well, you have, if you have draw ranger, you don't need to split push, honestly. Tied onto. I don't know.
I guess what it does do for you is that you can make up the numbers on your other lanes. You know, if draw ranger is pushing in and some kind of defense comes from a Kotl and a Kunkka towards the off lane, you TP Nature's Prophet behind the tower, and you find that Kotl, sprout, and dive. So it maybe gives you a bit of diving power with treants and things like that. So next heroes, no, I think we want to see a Dazzle, honestly. If you're going to go this all-in, you have to go full all-in.
Do you think maybe this is like a... Maybe like they're throwing them off as like a support Nature's Prophet or something? And Because why else would you pick it this early?
That could be cool, actually.
Are you invoking a reaction from them? Like, I mean, you have to invoke. That has to be your goal, right? You want them to sort of like either focus sort of on the Jesus Prophet and maybe like throw him off, or you just feel that ballsy. I don't know.
So in that case, you're thinking Nature's Prophet 4, Venge 5,
maybe.
with a Drow top, Puck mid, and then for the offlaner some kind of in your face brawling hero, right?
And in that sense, you can sort of run a dual offlane because, as you mentioned, the Nature's Prophet can always be there, right? So if you need him to, he can technically he could still be there. Maybe it does. Like the draw ranger does accelerate his form quite significantly in the jungle.
Interesting. Well, lock band, as well as that morphling. See the keeper, Kunkka, Tide. Unfortunately, player names are not showing up correctly here for either team.
Is this not on the ticket? That's the question.
It should be. But
yeah, it should be. I know, but maybe it might not because I don't think they're the correct names either. So that's what I'm wondering if.
I know at WSG they had these names. We didn't have a ticket there. They had these names instead of their correct ones. But like 4DR, King RD, they've got their correct names.
Oh, yeah.
I could take a look. So Spring is Tarvo, I'm pretty sure, because he plays their off lane. Number one is HFN, their safe lane player. Which leaves Son of a Beach as Cat, or C4T, as their final support. So the last hero for King R+4 is likely going to be HFN's safe lane hero. He's been playing a lot of Luna and stuff like that, kind of the regular sort of usual suspects. But I don't know if you can kind of throw Luna into the mix in this game. It's kind of a weird one. Maybe you look for a Timbersaw or something just to get that raw damage. But then you lack a tower punch. Oh, Sven. Sven's a good hero out here, I think. Get the Warcry for the bonus armor. You've got a hero that can jump on Drow Ranger with a blink, follow through with a tide. Lots of physical damage. Would be pretty nice.
And it's a hero that can benefit from all these setups. Like, you have the Kunkka, you have the Tidehunter to sort of set you up for a lot of hits, right? And I think Sven benefits immensely from just having other people stun for him.
I just noticed. I didn't even realize. Soggy Mitt's second player on the list. the profile picture and the name.
Yeah.
Both put together.
All right.
That's a 10 out of 10, actually. That's
The chat was way ahead of us.
Yeah, I know. I just looked over and someone in chat, he pogchamps at it. I look over again and then I see the name and then I realize the profile picture of who it actually
is. Yeah, seems like people can find it in Dota TV, so I guess it's not on the ticket.
Radiant team pick.
This is not the same. This is not going to be the same sniper as we saw from Sharks, I don't think.
Cool. I was looking for like a frontline hero that can just go and get stuff done.
Yeah, exactly. Same here. Because you need some sort of hero to tank for the Draw Ranger, right?
Yeah.
I guess Nature's Prophet Treants.
Yeah, I was going to say the same thing. Nature's Prophet, go for the the 4 null talisman with the blade mail build on Nature's Prophet.
No offense to Soggy Mets, and once again, once you say that, you're definitely going to offend them. But this draft looks
There's
like...
There's the butt.
this draft looks like something you concoct when you're 5 stacking at 1 a.m. or 2 a.m. You're having a really good time, and one of you guys randoms draw, and you're like, all right, let's go all in.
Yeah.
Because this is not necessarily a lineup, you see. It's incredibly risky. And there's so much backfire potential. Like, King Owl, they already have a lot of good heroes set up against this. They have the Keeper of the Light. They have the Legion Commander. The Mirana. They have so much deep push. And they have a lot of initiation.
Basically, if you lose your laning stage of Soggy Mitts...
Yeah, you lost.
The game is...
Wait. Can you... Nah, you can't level 1 Roshan.
I mean, you could.
I got excited for like 2 seconds, but I don't think you're gonna.
I don't think they will either. Well, King RD on the Kunkka. He's been playing a lot of that recently. Going to pass by Ghoul's Vengeful Spirit. Neither of them revealing each other. Venge, though, will get spotted by
there they are.
Tarvo. Tidehunter sees the Venge. Saw him
bench.
Going deep though, as the arrow tanked by the tree, and Nature's Prophet paying for himself already, but Ghoul unfortunately is walking into a dead end. This is not where you want to be. She's quick on her feet, 300 move speed, Torrent, We'll finally land. Tarvo doesn't really want to level anything up just yet because he wants to see how the lane is going to pan out. He's even holding onto money for the Iron Talon just in case he does have to go back into the jungle. Dodges another arrow.
He's wasting so much time.
He's wasting mana, I think, which is the bigger thing here, right? He's wasting this mana, which players need in the laning stage. Mirana needs that mana to kill off the range creeps in lane.
Oh, the torrent.
Oh my god, are you kidding me? Just being spam pinged, like, kill this little bitch, come on. Oh, the tower. Oh, after all that work, I mean, okay, finally dies down a bottom rune spot. Puck, as well as a sniper, getting whacked a little bit there by the Legion commander.
Is that Trelf? I'm being told that Trelf is in this team. Apparently he's the Draw Ranger.
Oh, really?
Are you triggered?
Why? He is. Oh. Trelf is on this team, according to joindota.com. The best site for match ticker and team details.
I checked it on Ghost.
Why?
Just kidding.
So
actually,
rude.
A joindota employee told me.
So rude. So Trelf is on the Drought Ranger?
Yeah. Cool. Trelf is on the Drought Ranger. Actually, we could have done... I don't know why, but I tried to look up the names of Dota for some reason.
And you could.
It's much easier for you. Yeah. The thing is, if I look it up on joindota or Ghost Games or whatever website, I trust that there's no human error, you know?
Hmm. Yeah. Everything is automated for sure. No humans come in contact with the data.
This laning stage. So it is a jungle Nature's Prophet, which I guess was clear the moment they picked the sniper, right? Because that's like with Tricorder, but just to come back to that. And he snipes a courier. This is the kind of game we're expecting now, I guess.
Yeah? You're all in? You're all in on every lane, you're all in every chance you get. I mean, there's three heroes kind of circling around this middle lane. Treants are here, helping out the sniper. Six and one.
There's a total of six heroes around the mid lane now.
It's a little bit insane. They've got 4DR leaping forward onto this sniper, looking for the X torrent, and I think King RD should be able to have this one. Venge and Nature's Prophet are coming in, though. The trouble is there's no Sprout, there's a magic missile, now Shrapnel comes through. Tarvo.
Body block.
Treant. Yeah, it's keeping
God.
In play.
Are they
and
doing
spring.
It again?
The Tidehunter is blocked as well. There's another magic missile soon, but not soon enough. Still needs six mana to launch that little stun out.
I mean, this lineup is working so far. You know, I will say I have much more confidence in Soggy Mids now that I know that this is... that Trelf is in here. Because obviously he's like a known player. And I think, for some reason... Just because I thought at first they're like no names. I mean, are these the open qualified teams? I think they are, right?
Yep.
King Now was the one that invited to the stage. So I think there's less confidence in this team if you don't know who they are. But was Trelf already? And Futsy? I know Futsy.
We're at trying to go in on Tide at top.
Magic missile.
The Venge dive in behind tier 1. Well, help secure the kill.
Swinging for that anchor smash. Puck denies himself or herself.
It's itself.
Itself, I guess. Technically, it's a he.
No.
If we go by the...
This is Dota 2. No, this is Dota 2.
All right.
If we were in Dota 1, it's a he. In Dota 2, there is no gender associated to Puck.
I was actually more talking about, you know, the Shakespeare.
Puck, oh, I mean...
Where the...
Sure.
Puck is clearly... No, whatever.
It's a camp male.
Alright, here's a question.
Don't assume gender in Dota 2, Skim. It really annoys people.
Here's a question. Do you think that denying to neutral creeps should be nerfed?
What do you mean?
It happened just twice now. Like the fact that a lot of times, and this, I think it started out as some sort of like thing that some people did, but now it happens way more frequently where players will deny themselves to neutral creeps instead of going back to base.
I think because it's only really useful in the early game, I think it's fine. I mean, what heroes does it massively benefit? Skywrath Mage does it a lot. You know, you go and spam out your entire mana pool, you go and kill yourself.
Yeah. That is actually annoying. I think that's actually the biggest abuse of that.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. I don't necessarily dislike it either, but I think just because it happens so frequently, it's probably something that it's on Icebox radar.
Good stun from 4DR, realizing The predicament he's in, the trouble is he leaps.
Oh my god.
Into the arms of the Nature's Prophet, the Fairy Fire and the Torrent are there, and now overrated. Get himself a little bit further away from the damage incoming from him, and the Bounty Rune will go to 4 DR, refill the bottle. It's a lot of damage, though.
The laning stage is working out for TSM, honestly. Nice. If you look at the offlane, sure, the puck is not getting a lot of farm, but it's an offlane puck. You're not supposed to get farm. You just want the level. The Draw Ranger and Venge are completely untouched top, as was sort of expected, and the Prophet has been involved in two kills, and he got a Courier.
Yeah, he's over farmed. Like, yeah. you've got phase boots, and I would honestly, like, I was joking about, semi-joking about the Null's Blademail, but I'd actually like to see, you know, maybe a couple of Null's. Maybe you think about going for a Force Staff or something like that, or a Dragon Lance, a Maelstrom, but I think get a couple of Null's and just go and run at people over and over again. Definitely could work out for you. The one upside here, of course, is that Legion Commander is farming very nicely on bottom lane. You know, keeping up in CS with the Drow Ranger, has phase boots, will be looking for that.
Oh, mid.
Jump tool as Sniper is caught, and a great combo there between 4DR and King RD, but turned around, the damage, the right click, ooh, just enough. Fairy Fire will not keep the Conqueror alive. But yeah, once the Legion Commander gets the jump tool, once Mirana gets up into your Aghanim Scepter, Tidehunter has that big old Ravage to defend these towers, the Drow strats love to push into, and especially since he has Iron Talon and a huge stack for himself over here, Tavo's going to have a great time getting into his items. I think the Soggy Mitts, sure enough, early stage of this laning phase has gone well, but it had to go well. They've made the most of the opportunities they've been given and made for themselves, but they're still in this really sort of awkward position where they can't slip up, right? They can't make any big mistakes.
Oh, for sure. They're in a very all-in kind of position, and they're going to feel this way throughout most stages of the game as well. Even if, say, they have like this sort of delay where they're not going to be able to break high. Oh, Charles, you're dead. It's the first duel win as well.
Yeah. Good rotation, and looks like they'll be able to take a huge chunk of HP off this tier one at top lane. The ping has come out saying, hey, if we're pushing top, they're
actually,
likely to push
DD,
bottom.
They can take this tower. Oh, I can't believe it. They're actually going to take the tower. It's the one lineup that doesn't have the Draw Ranger.
Taking the first tower.
Yeah. Looks like it. And I like how the Keeper of the Light immediately TP's bottom and makes sure that this bottom tower doesn't get scratched too much.
Yeah, immediately addressing the issue. Realizing that there's no defensive tier on top, so natural movement. Kind of expected return here for TSM is to go down towards bottom and maybe try and take the tier one here. Drow Ranger even comes and joins the fray with three bands of Elven Skin looking for the Treads and the Dragon Lance.
Oh, they found the Keeper of the Light. Yeah. That's a death coddle.
That sure is. They come in to try and kill off the Furin, and they will succeed as 4DR jumps out of the Sprout looking for Ghoul on this Vengeful Spirit cuts through the trees. But Venge should just get right click down here until the Drow Ranger slows things down with a gust, and now Ghoul behind the trees, but they've killed off the Tidehunter with a Dream Call down. The Assassinate comes out. No, it doesn't. Not even needed, and Ghoul has juked himself around? Away?
He's still alive. This is a massive juker. First that, you know, 0 minute juke, and now this.
Oh, this 4DR. Guy. Leap. And phase boots.
Assassinate.
Oh, he's dead, isn't he?
Alright. Soggy mids. They're doing it.
The solo mid.
Surprisingly, oh, I guess not surprisingly, now that I see that he doesn't have a TP. Imagine if Legion Commander had him. I think that's a bit of a different fight. Same with the Tidehunter. Though obviously he was farming in the jungle, so it was a bit low on mana and HP.
He just bought this Iron Talon, right? I'm not going crazy.
Who?
Legion Commander. Like, he didn't start with that, did he?
I don't think he bought it just now, but he's had it for a few minutes now. But
okay.
I don't think he had it early on. I think he bought it first and then.
Another pick on Kotl. Very fast burst through his HP there on the bottom lane. Nature's Prophet, Aquila Null phase, 1400 gold saved up. Drow Ranger has Treads and the makings of Dragon Lance, about 600 gold away from finishing it. The map is really starting to close in on King Owl plus four here. This aggressive Drow Ranger lineup with five ranged heroes working out wonders, as well as HFN caught on top lane, silenced up, stunned into oblivion. Moonlight Shadow's not going to work fast enough for you, especially with the Assassinate coming out of the Sniper. You can't do this as King Owl plus four. You cannot have one hero farming away on their own. It may feel like you're making space, or you've got space for this, but all of a sudden a Puck, a Drow, and Nature's Prophet, they're all on your head, and they are absolutely slaughtering you.
And this is the kind of thing that, well, we've been saying this all game, pretty much. Like,
Trelf is Fury and not Drow, apparently.
Oh, really?
According to chat.
Well, it makes sense, because, well, I guess because of the flame.
Whoever it is in this game, Trelf is one of them. That's a lot of damage. Oh, God, look at that.
Oh, God.
Nature's Prophet Treants, silent stop. He wants this duel, running into three heroes. You can't get it quite yet. He turns back to fight the Nature's Prophet, but it's still... Oh, Ravage comes through. The Drow Ranger finally going to die with the boat flying forward, but Puck and Furion will both escape. At least in the short term, as a TP comes in, the Torrent lands perfectly. They've got the duel as well to cancel out any further TP. And another win for HFN.
I like how he even X-mucked him during the duel. Just to make sure, no, you're not getting away. But,
oh, they're going to see this. Illuminate. Venge doesn't go in for it, though.
How is he solo HP?
No tranquils, man. Oh, it's the shrapnel. Where does it land?
Oh
no way!
What a player.
Welp.
Top lane again.
Oh, ooh, no,
they
dude.
They don't have any ultimates this time around.
Oh, no, dude. Sprout doesn't catch, though. Looks like Legion Commander gonna get a little bit out of danger as their dire team, they don't latch onto a single target and they can't actually finish anyone off, but I don't know. The way the Dire are farming is reasonably good here.
Yeah. Nature's
Prophet is the four role, kinda, right? But is second in net worth.
Radiant's top tower has been denied. Radiant structures are fortified.
Hmm. Okay. Puck now gonna go for a blink, gonna go to the Veil of Discord to just amp up his own magical damage.
Fine, they don't need the blink still. I'm a bit, I don't know, I feel like King Hour just giving them too much. Like we said time and time again, TSM need a almost perfect game, right? They can't really afford too many mistakes, although right now I think they have some sort of cushion where they can afford to, you know, give away like a kill or two.
Drums Aquila on that Nature's Prophet. It's just everyone buying as many stats as they can. We've got Dragonlance on the Drow complete. Dragonlance Sniper complete. Stats and more stats. And then you look at the item progression of the Radiant, and what have they got? You know, Phase Aquila, Mirana.
They have three green drops.
Against Puck.
Almost purely physical damage lineup.
I guess Assassinate and Puck's damage is... It's enough. Mana regen's good from the raindrops as well. It's just a great all-around item for the money you spend on it, honestly.
Just hater.
Are you really? I didn't notice. Finally a blink on the Legion. They can't really group up, though, and push into these towers. Still a rough one. Or maybe they can now. The mech is done for Tide. This might be a signal point for the Radiant team to actually... get themselves into position to take one of these tier 1s.
And they also... I mean, they have pretty much all the necessary levels on all of the heroes that they want.
There are three rings of Aquila on the Dire team. Shout out to Marauder Shields that just spotted that one. Three out of five. 60% of the Dire team has a ring of Aquila.
But Gareth, let me ask you this. How many lanes are there in the game?
There are three lanes!
Check.
Oh, that's amazing. Atheists, what now? Smoke into Dire Jungle, not going to amount to anything, but they do push into a tier 1, so they'll at least get some damage on here, and I think likely secure it. The fact that... Oh, are the Dire team planning on fighting this? They're going to be walking into Ravage Mech.
Like it, doesn't it?
Maybe they don't know about the mech. They definitely don't know about this high ground movement. Tide, he's hiding in the trees. They see the puck. The duel is there. Damage output looks like it's good enough to get the win as well. Now the boat into the Ravage. X mark as well onto the Vengeful Spirit. Sure enough, they commit heavy. Arrow. Oh, lands on the sniper. There we go. In you go, lads. Sniper X marked up again, and this battle that TSM thought they were going to be wandering themselves merrily into turns into an absolute slaughter.
They just ravaged for revenge.
Why the hell not? You ravage for 3 kills a tier 1 tower. You do lose a bit of momentum as Drow pushes bot tier 2, but it doesn't get any damage really dealt to it. Oh god, you're right. The duel in 10 seconds. I just need to buy some time here. TP in 3 from the Nature's Prophet.
So fast with the drums.
Oh, this duel. Oh, duel's not there. Not quite.
Timing.
And then the arrow flies across as well. Drowranger finds the Kunkka down in the Radiant Jungle somehow. The solo kills it and wanders into the Roche Pit. Zero. Decides he's had enough of the pushing and battling. He wants to be able to take Aegis and really consolidate what they've got.
Sure, why not? Ravage is out. And you know the Legion Commander's top, so I think they feel pretty safe doing this. Bit of a blunder. I don't think you give away Roshan that easily, do you? They're not even trading for anything. If you look at the positioning from the Radiant side, they're not getting much outside of farm, I guess.
Well, what could they trade for? You know, tier 1 top is gone. The bottom lane was pushed in by the Drow Ranger. I think it was really nicely set up there.
And the smoke from TSM as well.
Seem indecisive about where to go. Drow Ranger hits into the Ancients as well. Haste rune at the bottom spot. Drow can pick that one. Ravage down for what, another 40 seconds. This is a perfect window for TSM to actually go and play aggressively.
This coddle.
Oh, dearie me. They'll take the tier 1 for free. Keeper of the Light. Walks into the Venge. Obliterated, and so is King RD. The sniper from long range, stunned by the arrow, sure, but I've lost two heroes in quick succession, and now King R plus 4. What do you do? You've got one hero bottom lane. Tidehunter's farming away looking for what I assume is a Blink Dagger. There's no way for your Legion to jump in. Mirana wants to try and just throw a Starstorm to slow this one down, but look at that. HFN obliterated and burst down. Puck slides over the top, and that's an easy kill with a phase shift and stick charges. I think the Gust should be able to keep Loki alive, at least in the short term, as Tidehunter swapped back into the physical damage, throws his Ravage now. Drow still has the Aegis. They'll lose the Puck and the Venge. But Zero stands the ground and fights against 4DR. No leap just yet. The shrapnel secures the kill as well with the Drow Ranger whacking in onto them. Sniper, the boat. Oh, it's not going to connect just yet. King RD follows in and chases down onto the sniper, but Drow Ranger switches back onto the Cottle and Kunkka. X mark into Torrent. But Zero's not going to get caught by that one and should be a tier 2 secured for the Dire team.
Honestly, don't you just push like the other tier 2s now? Ravage is down.
Yeah, why not? I mean, you don't
I'm not even sure it was worth popping that Ravage there, because it was just the Mirana that followed up. I don't know.
It's just losing heroes one by one, right?
One by one, yeah.
You lose your Legion, you lose your Mirana, lose your Cottle, lose...
Speaking of Legion, can Legion even solo kill the...
We're about to find out.
Nope. I don't think that's enough. I mean, actually, if he gets lucky with procs.
I'm pretty sure if he had blade mailed, he would have.
Yeah, if he had blade mailed, he would have. Actually, that's a good
point. Is he okay? He dies to the nuke, right? Oh, he dies. Okay, Tide's here. Oh, JK.
It took me a while to see the Tide as
my,
well.
My brain was just working linearly. Like, it's a 1v1, it's a 1v1, it's a 1v1. I didn't even consider that another hero from another team could join in the fight. It was just like such a based 1v1 between them. Good gust there. As well as, Ghoul, Venge, finally caught off guard. These aggressive movements from Ghoul have always been pretty on the money, but finally Starstormed. Oh, going in, duel in 7, but they've got the X into boat, and Arrow will connect as well, with the sentry down.
Wait, what's the duel? 5 seconds on the duel.
Oh, well.
If you're Radiant there, you BM wait for him, and then duel him. Like, why? I don't know. That's a free duel win, honestly.
So 14 to 15, net worth, let's have a look. TSM had a decent lead, about 5k lead, but that's swinging back into King Ao now.
And King R still has plenty of towers to take.
I definitely do. Blink for the puck finally arrives. Well, this is obviously the weakness of the draft we were talking about. The laning stage has to go well, you have to then move that into mid-game. And you need to be knocking on tier 3s by like 25 minutes and taking tier 3s and racks with the lineup you've got here from the Dire. And if you don't, things can spiral out of control because you give some farm room here over to King Owl plus 4. Legion Commander starts stacking up damage. Now the DD rune looking for the Shadow Blade. Actually not finishing off the Desolator, which I thought was going to be the next item. But team bonus armor stats and long range shenanigan bollocks here from the Dire team. Their window's closing.
It is. And if you look at the form distribution, if you look at the net worth graph, actually Legion Commander is taking the lead now. If you look at the sniper as well, I think this is almost reminiscent. This is very reminiscent, actually, of Slash Strike, and I guess it comes back to the hero not being a flesh farmer, but he is falling behind in farm, and I will say that just because of the draw range aura, he's always going to deal a lot of damage, but...
Does it matter if he's behind in farm when he's in love with this cute girl?
That's actually a good point.
Maybe it's unrequited love, though. Maybe the cute girl doesn't love him back.
I've watched enough anime... to know that the power of love and friendship can increase your damage.
Say no to anime.
Are you the one that said he would delete every hero from his friend list if he had to?
Yes.
Every hero, every friend. All right.
Anyone with an anime profile picture gets removed. Doesn't matter
or
who.
Name?
Doesn't. Names I can kind of live with because they are. I can see the appeal in them, you know. They are kind of like, heh, that's kind of edgy and cool. But
XD
Lamau. But profile pictures with some... I don't even want to talk about it, honestly. Like whatever.
Smoke coming out from King Owl now. I like this. Oh,
sick duel!
Yeah, that duel was... It's very unfortunate, though. If you're King Owl, you're in a position where you're like, all right, guys, let's do something. Oh, instant duel. Oh, that's an illusion.
And then Puck walks back into the Legion just to rub salt in the wound. Like, ha! You dueled my illusion, and now I'm gonna show you the real one.
Interesting that they decide to go this aggressively with their smoke without the Legion Commander. The Legion Commander is a significant portion of their damage.
Cottle.
I like how he ran away from the wrench. You're like, oh, you didn't see me. Oh, you didn't
well,
see
he
me.
Ran away from the rest of his team, and now his team is dying as well. 40-yard drops to the Drow Ranger. The boat will slow the advance down a little bit, maybe give King RD a little bit of time to escape. But that sequence of events was just wrong.
Like, they seem a bit scrambled, don't they?
They moved to high ground as a team, except the Cottle. Then Cottle doesn't follow because he doesn't want to give away the rest of his team's position. And then... retreats away from the range creep, then dies, then the rest of the team thinks, right, now's our time to strike, we're 4v5, this is when we're strongest, and then Drow just kills the Marana. And just
yep.
Wonky.
And this is the kind of thing you really cannot afford. Like, alright, playing against the Drow lineup, any Drow lineup really, is already difficult enough, right? Because Drow is just one of these heroes that just is a pain in the butt. But you cannot afford easy mistakes like this. Like, there's no reason for the Keeper to die there. There's no reason for the Marana to die there either. Really.
Yeah. I mean, TSM do carry this damage for the next, like, 20 minutes. I guess we should clarify. The window we were talking about is the fact they don't have a frontline hero to kind of go and stand high ground. They've got this window where they'll have an advantage with the items they've got to actually just... end the game, and that easy window of ending the game kind of closes on them. Not the game's over window. They still do have a really
Conquer.
Strong draft oh, here. Conquer. And you just see the damage come out, but in comes Tarvo, the duel, and the Ravage onto the Drow Ranger Taker out of the game. And the winner onto the Legion as the sniper. Doesn't quite finish the Cottle Will with the shrapnel, not the shuriken. I don't know where that came from. Puck blinks away back to safety. A 2-for-1, the Drow, the only casualty, but that's a number of ultis down from King Owl plus 4.
And they invested, what, 3 ultis, I guess? Although obviously a lot of their ultis don't necessarily have that high of a cooldown. It's a start. Delaying this lineup by killing the draw is incredibly important. Like, one draw kill buys you, what, 5 to 10 minutes, maybe? Depends, I guess. But yeah, it's important. And you can see TSM, they do not even think about fighting with a draw down, because that's like half the damage. Obviously not the draw itself, herself, but also the aura.
Yeah, the aura is definitely the big one.
Yeah.
Well, Maelstrom.
Two Maelstroms on the Dire side now.
And have that Lincolns on the Nature's Prophet as well to make sure there's no...
Instantly going for Rush.
No instant
Whoever's
duel.
Making the calls on the Dire side is doing a good job. Because if you look at the movement, it almost seems as if no movement as for the team as a whole is wasted. It always has a purpose. They're like, alright, we're pushing this lane out, we're pushing this lane out, we're taking this objective, we're securing this area by dropping a ward, and let's immediately take a Rosh once the draw pops back out.
Tarvo, not a solitary fuck to give, blinks in without Ravage, just to slow this one down. King RD is taking a pummeling here though, throws the torrent onto that short ramp. His Legion wins a duel in the back end, but now Drow Ranger caught a little bit off guard with the X back. No control just yet, but taking a chunk as the Assassinate finishes off another Legion. Caught in the trees and right-clicked into Oblivion. This is a great chasing power now from TSM, looking for another one. There's a fourth. And the fifth is the Morana escaping back towards mid lane. But TP'd on by the Nature's Prophet. Leap in 10, Sprout is there. Arrow, easy to connect, but it's a full five-man wipe. Soggy Mitts makes short work of them, and then back into Roshan they go.
Do you even still go for Rosh? I think you just go straight down the... I mean, obviously they're doing both now. But...
I guess
you take the Rosh fast enough and just take it. It's not big of a delay. I was just wondering, because if they're all down, don't you just push high ground? Take the tower? Because right now it's just the Prophet doing it.
He's doing a decent amount of damage, though, with that Drow Aura. He's doing 268. Like Tralf. Actually, take the tier 3 down to a third of its HP. In comes the Tide with Gush, and. I mean, does he Ravage here?
No, the
They've
X.
They've got X mark just in time, actually.
That's force damage, X.
Torrent Boat, not the best, but. Nature's Prophet is struggling to think of how he escapes from this one, and in fact, he will not. X mark back into death, and. Finally find the kill on him. The rest of his team went back to farming instead of actually moving from Roshan towards that tier 3 middle lane. They were low on mana though, so it's kind of expected that they would dip back to regen in the fountain for a little bit.
I just wonder if maybe there was a missed opportunity there to deal some more structure damage. I guess they would have only killed the tier 3. Again, they killed Roshan almost immediately, so it's not that big of a deal. But yeah, why did King Ao even take that fight at Roshan? They didn't have Ravage. They did not even have vision, if I remember correctly. Like, proper vision anyway. I don't know. Felt kind of weird. And they were scrambled as well. The Tide Hunter was on one side with Kunkka, and then the Legion with the Potom was on the other side. It felt very forced. Like, guys, let's not give them Aegis, even though we really can't fight it.
Yeah, it was a weird one. I think they just wanted to slow things down and delay the Roshan until their ultis came back up. Because, like, if the Radiant jump in there and, you know, they posture and they pretend to fight, maybe they can buy themselves enough time for Ravage to come back off cooldown. But regardless, Aegis held by Sniper now with the smoke through their own jungle. I think they know that Legion. Yeah, they definitely know Legion's around.
Wow.
Sentry's right there. No magic missile. I'll hold on to it for as long as they can.
And they cyclone the Kunkka. Alright, that's just a support Kunkka. Let's not make a big deal of it, but still. Getting two kills here is very nice. Unfortunately, or fortunately for King Ao, they pushed out this lane quite significantly. The mid lane as well, and Tide Hunter is pushing out the bottom lane, so. By the time they do knock on the door, the Kunkka is going to be back up, and Legion Commander almost as well. Hurricane Pike now for the Sniper.
So many big items from the Dire team.
Yeah. They're hitting these timings incredibly fast. And you can see, if you look at the net worth, this pickup, this Maelstrom Mjolnir pickup for the sniper accelerated his farm significantly.
Tier 2 top lane, do you really want to defend this, King Owl? Arrow! Slides past the Drow Ranger. I could think about no, not like this! That's not how you do it. The Puck will escape. Four staff back to safety. The boat, it's not going to do a damn thing. They TP in some more people here to throw their spells. They do get the duel onto Sniper, but he holds the Aegis. Not a big kill at all, while Drow Ranger comes back in with a right click, throwing these Frost Arrows down, but they've killed the Venge in the back end at the very least. Tidehunter inside the Sprout. Apparently taking no damage whatsoever here as he got Anchor Smash and he's got the Greaves going on him. And Morana leaps back to safety. Yules by the Puck now runs away. That was interesting from both teams. One hero dies, but the Radiant bust all of their ultimates.
I think the fight went much better for the Radiant than it should have. Like, you blow the Ravage on just one hero, you duel the Aegis hero, and you still almost win the fight. Because if you look at if you looked at TSM's health, they were really, really low after that fight.
Oh, Nature's Prophet nearly got slapped by that nice little sidewinder from 4DR coming in through the trees. Maybe for the Dire team, it's now a case of waiting for the next Roshan to come back up. Keep your farm game going. Keep these lanes pushed out and make sure you just don't get solo picked off by the Legion Commander. That's the big threat, right? Is Legion going around and taking duel after duel win.
Oh, for sure. You definitely need to be scared of that. She, by the way, has a Halberd, which I think she had in the fight before. I saw a lot of misses, even before the Blinding Light.
Yeah. Had it for a little bit. And we're seeing sentries being placed down as frequently as possible by this Vengeful Spirit. Nature's Prophet still hiding back in this little nook in the trees as HFN.
It's very unlikely he's going to find him.
I don't know, dude. They're pinging.
Oh my god.
How do they know?
No.
How do they know?
Oh my god.
How do they know?
So close. Nah, alright, then. They're just very good at guessing.
They're like, where could he be? He must be here. They scanned. And then he's gone.
Did they scan?
Yeah, they did.
Alright.
Radiant scanned, yeah.
Alright, that makes it more legit.
But they were pinging and moving before they scanned. They scanned to make damn sure.
I guess it sort of makes sense to be there. Maybe. It's a nice nook to hide in.
Like, he's not farming jungle, right? You've not seen him move back into the jungle. You know Nature's Prophet is somewhere pushing lanes because you've seen Treants come out and that, but very close to killing him off. Dire's top tower is under attack. Push comes in bottom lane, though.
It's a bit scary for King now that two lanes are being pushed in.
Nature's Prophet just TPs into like the middle of three of them. They don't jump him though. Legion holding onto that Blink Dagger, a little bit afraid of who's coming, but the Sprout gives vision of the Legion, and yeah, Nature's Prophet realizes this is not where he wants to be. Denies the tower, and now he can even think in 5 seconds' time of TPing back towards the fight, because mid lane and bot lane are both being shoved in super hard here by the Dire.
I wonder, can he solo kill the Keeper?
Who? Furion?
Prophet.
Yeah.
With his ultimate.
He's got four staff and blinding light. Maybe not. Because there's no stun on Nature's Prophet, right? So, Kotl just like blinding light, four staff TP. And then you can't kill him.
Because Kotl's playing very. Well, not aggressively by any means, but he's out there.
Well, like, what's the kill power from Dire Team to kill him? They need either Venge, Puck.
Oh, they have a long range of initiation just with a Puck, Venge, even a Sniper.
But I mean, if he Blinding Lights any initiation, then TPs, they need a stun to cancel a TP. Yes. So it's Venge or Puck, really. Assassinate on its final hit will mini-stun, but I guess that's one thing that TSM are lacking, you know, is the big teamfight ultimates or the actual hard lockdown here. It's all damage. They have drafted literally all damage.
That's what we said during the draft, right? As the last pick, we were looking for something tanky, something maybe like a Sand King, maybe like a centaur axe, something that just is tanky and can initiate and can be the front line, basically.
Yeah, a damage sink.
Yeah.
Or even an ulti sink. I mean, Puck and Nature's Prophet have done a great job so far of baiting out spells and making sure that ravages are thrown and duels are wasted.
No, just the TP because it comes in from the bench.
He's standing in the middle of the treants.
Oh, alright.
You get some procs out of his passive as Nature's Prophet does kill the Kunkka in the back end, but they're chasing down the Moonlight Shadowed HFN with the Moonlight Shadow relocate, though. Recall even from the Keeper of the Light. And back we go. Top lane. Drow Ranger's considering going in on Tide here. You've got Gust and a decent amount of damage, but Tide is tanky as all hell. Now, looking aggressively to push forward onto the Drow. The TP from the Nature's Prophet is coming in. Purple on the side. Morana getting ready to join the action, but there's another Shadow Blade here, and I guess there's no reveal from the Radiant, right? Nature's Prophet looking for a kill. Drow Ranger rejoins. Arrow lands on Furion, though, in the back end, and Zero might be in a spot of bother. They've got a blink from Legion. He's looking for it. The Ravage catches all three. Legion going to duel up the Puck on the side. Drow Ranger trying to get the Tide to back off. But, oh, this Tarvo Tide is not retreating. A double kill for Legion. As Nature's Prophet TP's back.
Was the Drow Ranger trying to bait them into, like, a bad engagement? I for the life of me, cannot figure out why they stuck around for so long. You have to realize that there's some sort of rotation coming. I mean, the tier 2 is still here. So technically somebody could have TP'd and walked up there. I don't know. It felt very weird. It felt like somebody made a call, but maybe somebody else didn't follow through because only the Puck rotated. It was pretty weird.
You're asking a question to which I do not know the answer, my
Yeah,
friend.
I know. I'm just trying to theory craft what the idea behind that engagement was. Either way, they got the draw kill, and I mentioned it earlier. If you get the draw kill, you buy yourself 5-10 minutes.
Well, now we're looking at 124 bonus damage. What's is that a Shiver's Guard for your Tidehunter, 200 gold away? But my question was going to be Legion Commander. While we're paused, let's play Guess the Item.
Where's she? Oh, she's actually at the secret shop. All right.
My guess,
good question.
Assault
Maybe
Cuirass.
A heart? Oh, Assault Cuirass. Oh, yeah, for sure. Oh, of course, yeah. You need it.
Are you sure?
You need all... I don't know.
Is that your final answer?
Let me think.
I think Shivers Untied and Assault Cuirass on the Legion is huge for you.
With all the physical damage, all the armor that you can need, stack it up.
Well, Roshan has returned to the battlefield with cheese this time. And the Dire not having their Drow and their Puck. I'm not sure if the Radiant can actually get in there. King R plus 4 might have some struggles moving across the map just because all their lanes, they keep getting pushed in.
Yeah.
Definitely a difficulty they have to try and deal with somehow.
And see, this is one of these things. If the Drow Ranger was alive right now, TSM just take it within, what, 10 seconds, 15, 20 seconds at this point? All the physical damage they have? Because she's not alive, what King now can do, they can push out the lanes and prepare themselves for better Roshan fight. You know, they take a tower?
It's a lot of damage on that Legion, honestly. I mean, they were pinging and moving into position to kind of get high ground around Ancients and the large camp over towards the side. I just go straight in for tier 2, not going to finish it off just yet. 4DR. I think they know there's wards. Aghanim's Nature's Prophet. We were scared of the push power of TSM. It's going to get even stronger.
HFN just barely misses the Prophet, and with this, that's a free Roshan. Hero was commending the way they position themselves. Ooh. Calls for Roshan.
That torrent delayed it a little bit, but.
Yeah.
Wait, hang on a second. They've just walked past the Kunkka. They're scouting in the back to try and see if they can find anyone else. They're repositioning. But they've just run past the Kunkka. If they had known, like if they had vision, like they're pinging now saying, oh look, there they are. But they could have killed that Kunkka easily and probably gone into Roshan. Or just moved forward as a group and kind of swarmed their way into the Radiant team. But Treants are being spammed out across the map and into these tier 3s.
Oh, Conker.
Dear lord.
Not again.
Okay. They catch him this time, and it's the gem on the deck. The tide comes in. Arrow to give him some safety, but is he safe enough? He forced that forward. There's the Ravage down onto a couple. Venge, though, is the only one to really drop from this. Sniper and Drow both retreating further backwards as Legion. Well, you're in this battle. Racks are falling. You're fighting. You're fighting 4v5. Nature's Prophet is in your base destroying buildings. Tied under being kited and zoned around as Tarvo tries to retreat. The entirety of the Radiant team trying to retreat, but Puck juking back and forth. Melerak's gone now. Drow kills the Keeper of the Light, and in jumps the dueling Legion Commander. Is it going to be enough? Do they have time? Do they actually get the win? It does look like they do. Legion finds the win, but still loses her life. I might have to buy back as...
Is he? He's TPing out. Oh my god, he TPed out in front of two heroes and a tower.
Yeah.
Oh my god. That is heartbreaking for King Owl. If you're King Owl, you're just mentally drained from this. Like, god damn it. Not like this.
Oh,
literally 38 damn. Minutes. You do kinda well, actually. I think King Owl were doing a pretty good job this game. They killed the Draw Ranger plenty of time to make sure they delay the push, and then get ratted.
I just feel for King Owl plus 4. Fighting 4v5, losing your Kunker, dogpiling in, decent team fight, and then you realize that there's a guy in your base, and there's no way you can disengage. You need to continue fighting, because you're going to get tracked down by Dream Coils and Orbs and all sorts of stuff. Like Hurricane Pikes, right? They've got one on the Sniper. They should have one soon on the Drow Ranger, but I guess the Shadow Blade kind of replaces that mobility item. We've been seeing that build more often, treads into Dragonlance and Shadow Blade. But
it's kind of nuts that they had such a good start to the fight. The first out Ravage was beautiful. It was like a 4-man Ravage, I think?
I think they caught 3, but the phase shift Puck juked it. So they caught like the Sniper Drow Venge, but yeah, it was a pretty decent one.
But they couldn't really capitalize. They weren't in a really good position. HFN got kited around so much. I think you could see almost how he wasn't really sure what to do. He's like, do I go back to base to defend it? Do I stay in this fight? If I do stay in this fight, who do I kill? Because he just wasn't in a good position at the start of the fight.
I want to try and fight top lane. 4DR yulzed up, there's no X mark back, and down goes the Mirana. Sniper on a godlike streak here, and the 5-man movement forward. Nature's Prophet is farming Ancients, but can actually TP towards bottom lane if he wants to take down that tier 3 there. Looks like the defense should be mounted from the Radiant.
By the way, we haven't really talked too much about honestly.
Oh, they've got a duel onto Sniper. We'll come back to that in a second. The Ravage, but the swap is good. They've caught 4, but the BKB from the Drow Ranger holds the high ground. Oh, Hurricane Pike. Legion can't stick on a target, and Puck will retreat back to safety of the high ground. In comes Overwhelming Odds, and wow, Legion does a good chunk back onto them, but it's just so difficult sticking onto them. King RD and Tarvo both drop with Nature's Prophet still on bottom lane. They've had to split their efforts, and this Radiant team have to start buying back now, sooner rather than later, just to defend their base.
Sniper has been sitting in the backline with 100 HP just hitting everybody. I think it was a double Hurricane Pike that saved him. Was it a double? What? Something saved him.
It was definitely a Hurricane Pike, but.
Hurricane Pike, but what pushed him? Was it the Blinding Light actually that pushed him away?
I mean, they've got.
Initially?
No other Force Staffs or anything, right?
Yeah. Because to me it looked like it was two Hurricane Pikes, because the way he got pushed away from a duel looked like it was intentional from like a teammate, right? But. Was it unfortunate if it was? It had to be the Blinding Light then. It had to be the Blank Knight. He got pushed uphill. It's unfortunate.
Nature's Prophet did die to the Mirana, it seems.
Yeah, she hunted him down. It was just pretty. Well, he had everything on cooldown.
Dagon, Aghanim's, Starstorm, as well as that Manta style. Nature's Prophet, you know, got a reasonably good array of items there. Necro 3 and Boots of Travel are now up for him as well. Nasty, nasty stuff.
But yeah, the point I was trying to make before the fight is I think the Puck has had a really good game. We sort of talked about him a little bit here and there, but quite frankly, considering it's an offlane Puck is awful. In most cases, anyway. And he didn't really get much out of the lane in terms of farm. He just tried to get as much XP as possible. And I think his item choices were really great as well. The Veil worked out fine for them. And then the Yulz is... I think he set up, what, half of the kills he has been part of set up with the Yulz.
Hunting time. This is an Aegis sniper. They'll take life one. And now they look for Venge on the back end. They've taken life two. Look for life three. BKB TP. There's nothing to stop
bottom
it.
Bottom lane.
Oh god. Are they fighting a losing battle here? Well, looks like one Rax is gone. Melerax is still standing, but Major's Prophet's committing for this. Unfortunately, not for the better, as he will try and TP himself. Wait, hang on. They've got
what?
No vision inside. No way. He's out. He's gone, dude. And the chase is on. Loki looking for the Tidehunter. Doesn't have the Dream Call anymore, though. Arrow.
What capitalize on
what is even happening? There's like three fights happening at once. TP, Nature's Prophet. Oh, the leap is there.
Puck, he wants him.
Puck.
Wants him.
I think you know.
Oh, he didn't
see him. Oh, dear.
Oh,
dear.
Oh, no. Does he want him to go back in?
Come on, HFN. Let's go, buddy. Hey. Oh. Let's go. TP in. The gust is down. Blade mail. Not going to save you from this, I don't think. It slows down the aggression, but still HFN dies. Legion, Legion, Legion. No buyback. 90 seconds dead on the sidelines. And now you've got to cry a tear for King Owl plus 4. Because I think this game might end.
Honestly. TSM, they like so well. Like this Prophet especially. Not only obviously because of his coverage. I think that's way too easy to just say, alright, he took a lot of racks, he's a good player. No, his early game impact was incredible. And now he's taking the bottom racks.
He's got Lincolns to stop the X-Mark. Blinding light. Damage is good. He will finally die, but in the meantime you're losing top as well. Tide. Holds onto the Ravage, he's silenced with the Kraken Shell. Popsy throws it at the last second. The BKB from Drow. I mean that she doesn't get stunned or anything. And this final lane of Varrox here, without your Tide, without your Legion. Foregone conclusion, really, as King Owl plus 4. They blink in aggressively, look for the kill on Avenge, but they can't even secure that. Good game's called. Soggy Mitts, they take game number one here in this best of three skim.
I'm so happy Soggy Mitts and not, let's say, Evil Geniuses. Profits in the next week, at clubs. But incredible. I mean, we sort of looked down, or I wouldn't say looked down on them, but we questioned the draft from Soggy Mitts, right? Because this was like an all-in draft. But they executed this incredibly well. I don't think I've seen a draw lineup, or an all-in draw lineup executed that well in a while now. Partly because not everybody goes all-in on draw ranger these days, but still.
Yeah, I think decision-making was great. The split-pushing and the ratting was kind of what brought it all together, right? That Nature's Prophet from the four roll.
At the end of the day, though, if you look at it, it was just icing on the cake. It wasn't necessarily like, you could say, all right, the split-push is what broke down King O. I guess it sort of did during that fight, but up until that point, they were still dominating the game to a degree just because of their decision-making and the general draw ranger push style,
yeah.
Kind of.
But it's one of those things, it's a break from the meta. You're so expecting, like, a team fight or a pick into high ground break with a hero that stands high ground and you do damage from the back lines. Whereas this was fight on the opposite side of the map or fight somewhere that's awkward and disadvantageous to the Radiant team. And then Nature's Prophet is ratting and splitting like we used to see from Bulldog. You know, you're winning fights 4v5 because of the lead you've got. And it was something we were scared of, is consolidating the lead here from the Dire team. But they did it in a way that we didn't really expect, because it hasn't been done in a long time, and probably something that King Owl plus 4 didn't expect for the same reason. They didn't consolidate their lead through, you know, just towers and just taking Roshan. They did it through shoving lanes and really trying to bait these fights onto their side of the map. It's a Drow strat that's fighting in their jungle and on their side of the map instead of fighting underneath enemy towers, I think was the big surprise and the big kind of middle finger to the Radiant team.
It kind of was.
But yeah, game number two coming up. It is a best of three, of course. We'll take a short break and we'll be right back.